The fire effect is available in HitFilm Pro and the destruction add-on pack for Express. Today we're going to be going over the settings so that you can better understand how to use it. I've previously utilized this effect to create my underworld title, which also has a tutorial. I'm Javert Valbar for inScapedigital.com. Let's get started. Most of this information is pulled from the online HitFilm manual, but it helps to see the effect in action as well. Here I have a plane and a text layer. I'll add the fire onto the plane. Hide the text by clicking the eye. If I press play, the entire plane will be set on fire. We'll go down the list of settings so that you can see what each parameter does. The flammable region is exactly what it sounds like. This determines where the fire will take place. If I select the text layer, it will be restricted to that area. The blocking region sets where the fire should not be. If I select the text layer again, the flames will be everywhere but that area. You can move the text around and it will update accordingly. For the purposes of this tutorial, I'll set the flammable region to the text area and leave it at that. Moving on to burn direction, which uses another layer as well. If you have any experience with creating gradient maps to control procedural effects, this is what that is. I'm going to show you how that works now. Let's drag in the plane from the media panel and add the color gradient effect. I'll turn the opacity up, then position the two ends to go from left to right. The black color will be the start point for the fire, and the white will be the end. I'll drag this layer to the bottom. Now, if we set the burn direction to use this layer, it won't work. It changes, but it should be going left to right. This is because it's using the layer without any of the effects. That's just how HitFilm's render order works. So all it sees is the color black. To solve this, you can either make the gradient its own composite shot, or you can use a trick that I learned from Simon Jones. First, create a grade and place it above the gradient layer. In the burn direction settings, select the grade layer instead. You can now see the blaze is burning left to right. The grade layer flattens everything below it. When the burn direction setting looks at the grade, it sees the plane with the gradient on it. The benefit of doing this over pre-composing is that I can stay in this composite shot, adjust the gradient, and see the immediate results. I'll remove the burn direction for now and leave it at default. Let's move on to simulation. The seed property is present in most procedural effects in HitFilm. It generates a random instance of the entire simulation. This is true for other things like fractal noise and the particle simulator. If you need to change the whole effect at once, adjust the seed. More iterations will create a more realistic simulation of the flame's movement. In this case, it doesn't really change anything. I'll leave it at 100. The pre-start allows you to have the fire start before the composite shot begins. It's measured in frames. If I type in 15, and move my playhead to 0, the effect will already be 15 frames into the simulation. The flammable end does the opposite. It controls when the inferno disappears. I'm not sure why it changes the appearance at the beginning, or sometimes continues to show flames after the number has been set. This might be unintended behavior, or I'm reading the manual wrong. The source scale controls the size of the initial fire textures. If I come to the beginning here and lower it, more dots will appear, and this will result in softer flames. The source variation adjusts how often the fire changes formation. Low variation will create smoother, less volatile flames. Source fill changes how much of the original layer is filled with fire. It also could be considered the overall density. Movement is pretty obvious. If you want your fire to stay still, keep this low. Source noise adjusts the randomness of the textures that generate the fire. If you turn this down, it'll become more uniform. Source intensity is kind of similar to source fill, and they pretty much do the same thing. Activating the reload maps property creates a more realistic simulation when the flammable region is animated. So, if the text was keyframed or the source was visually dynamic, you'd want this checkmarked. Finally, the source position moves the whole fire simulation. You can combine this with 2D tracking if your shot involves a moving camera. The wind controls push the flames in a specific direction, similar to the burn direction we did earlier. Only two settings here, angle and strength. The appearance dropdown is where you can change the color and blend modes. The high and low temperature sliders control how white hot the flames appear and how much detail is visible. Lowering the high temperature makes them more white, and raising the low temperature gets rid of the darker red areas. When you're using the fire effect in your project, remember that you have numerous other effects available to enhance it. I wouldn't recommend just using fire by itself, even though it does look pretty good. Add in some anamorphic lens flares, gleam, light streaks, or diffuse. Let me know if you have any questions below. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all in the next video.